So next, BA Edmond, I used to work with in-house costumers only, or we as a company used to work with in-house costumers only, but now we're open to external costumers. However, to work with you, it's your work. It's the body of work that you've done, how much work you've done, what ideas that you have. I'm open to working with, especially within this department of costume and styling and all that. I'm open to new ideas. You first need to ask yourself, are you a shopper or do you actually create costume? Do you design and make? How fast are you? Speed is a very, 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 very integral part of how I choose costumers. There are a lot of stylists within the music video industry, not a lot of costumers. So are you a stylist? And the difference between a stylist and a costumer is that a stylist's creativity is based a lot on shopping and combination. Maybe not even necessarily shopping, but combinations, how to put together combinations. A costumer, on the other hand, apart from just making costumes, adds a lot of their own creativity into being able to design the clothes that characters wear. Works very, very closely with the art department in terms of how they derive colors, how the costumes react to light. Costumers, in my experience, are more vast with that experience, just being able to work with the other departments, not just in isolation. So if you want to be a costumer, I would say that you should aim to work a lot more on film sets and television sets that would push you, all right, and make help you create that body of work. So if a music video production company sees your work on that level, then they know for a fact that you can work on their set, both for music videos and commercials, because you are a costumer and your work is that vast. So essentially, try to start from the top of the food chain when it comes to the one that stretches you the most. And it's not easy. It means that you have to build yourself a lot. If you want to be a music video costumer / stylist, well, then it's the body of work that you have and your speed, how fast you are, and how easy it is to work with you. That's one thing that people don't emphasize on a lot. A lot of times people would pick artisans that are easy to work with and are not necessarily as good as those who are difficult to work with, but they would pick them over those who are really good and are difficult to work with. Again, people would pick artisans that are easier to work with and are learning and are dedicated over people who are difficult to work with but are very good. And what you find is those guys who aren't like the best but are easier to work with and are progressive in their thinking and are learning would get up to the level of being as good, if not better, than those who are really good and are difficult to work with. There is such a thing as natural talent. I believe that, right? And it applies. But within the scale of things, dedication and people skills would trump awesome skill that is difficult to work with any day. Now, difficult to work with isn't, oh, this is my process, or this is how I believe the work should be done. If you are difficult to work with because you are dedicated to the work itself, to the craft itself, then the people that you're working with don't get it. And that's understandable. In fact, that doesn't mean that you're difficult to work with. It just means that some people would like to say it means that you're professional. If you being difficult is because of the way the work should be done and the ethics that you apply to your work, that's different from you just being an ass. Big difference.